Mic check one. Mic check.
Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. We come to give God praise this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's the mighty God. Come on, hallelujah. If you know that God is worthy, can you put your hands together this morning? Hallelujah. We come to bless his name this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord is good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And his mercy endures forever. Hallelujah. We give you praise, oh God. Hallelujah.
Friend.
Serve a God that's worthy of all the praise, honor, and glory. Are you excited to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Are you glad to be alive in the land of the living? I'm going to ask you to please stand for the call to worship, and then I'll turn it over to the worship leader. Amen. Sister Lyric Jackson. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he that made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name, for the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made, we will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. At this time, we'll have our worship leader take over, Sister Lyric Jackson.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Will everyone please remain standing for our opening selection by our praise team.
Our hands face to the world. We come to lift our hands face to the world.
our morning prayer by Taylor Brooks and a welcome by Cannon Fountain.
Amen. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Let us go into prayer. Thank you, God, for this beautiful day. Bless everybody that is here today and those who cannot make it. Heal anyone that is sick or hurt. Bless the service and bless our Terrius as he brings us the word of God. All these blessings I ask in your name, in your Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to Jerusalem. Whether you are a longtime member or a first-time visitor, we are very glad that you're here with us today. At Jerusalem, we believe that each person who walks through these doors is here for a purpose. It has a purpose, and today we have a service for you. As we go into worship, lift your voices and hearts in praise with us to our amazing God.
Yes.
And be sure to share a smile, a handshake, or maybe even a high five with someone here before you leave today.
Amen.
Now let's prepare our hearts and minds as we enter into a time of worship together, and let's get ready to encounter God in a powerful way.
Amen.
Good job, Taylor and Cannon.
Amen.
Now we will have two selections by the Sunbeam Choir.
Just one.
And then we have Praise Dance by Praise in Motion, the Youth Recognition by the Youth Ministry.
Thank you.
Good morning. Today I'll be reading from Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. He said to me, "This is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. We are asking if you're sitting on the front row to please move back a row, and if you're sitting toward the middle to please scoot outwards, and if the choir would like to come down to watch, they can do so at this time."
morning, church. First of all, I want to say thank you. I'd like to say thank you to all the youth that took a part of the program, the service today. We encourage all other youth to come and be a part of the service every fourth Sunday for Youth Sunday. Just a couple announcements before I do the recognition. We are having the Easter egg event next Saturday on the 30th from 1 to 3. Encourage you to bring all the youth out. We're going to have a good time. Let's see what else. Please submit your youth accomplishments. We're trying to put together a youth newsletter to just let the youth know that we're thinking about them and their accomplishments and things that they do around the community and school and at home. So the reason I'm here, the youth recognition for this month, we are recognizing the youth of our church, and that would be Miss Hattie Rose. Hattie is a current third grader at Randolph Elementary School. She is very inquisitive and loves to learn. She is willing to help with almost anything if she can. She loves to sing, dance, play games with her family, play with her dolls, riding her bike, or just being outside, period, and singing in the choir with the mic.
Yes.
Hattie is enjoying her first year as a Girl Scout in Troop 124. And in her first year, she sold over 200 boxes of cookies. She loves her family, friends, church, and families, and all above, she loves God. Thank you. Thank you.
Sorry. Congratulations to Hattie Rose. Now it is time for offering. We will have offering by the ushers, our offertory selection by the praise team, offertory prayer by one of the deacons, and then the doxology.
Thank you.
done is bad for the offertory prayer. Oh, wise Heavenly Father, again we come, thank you for your many blessings. Heavenly Father, we come bringing back a portion of what you have blessed us with. Heavenly Father, we ask that you bless this offering in a mighty way right now. And Heavenly Father, bless those who have it to give and bless those who did not have it to give. And may this offer be used for the uplifting of your kingdom here on earth. In Jesus' name I do pray. Amen.
Church clerk, the pastor's emphasis by Brother Harris, and then sermonic selection by our praise team, and then the spoken word from Artarius Robbins.
Amen. Good morning, Jerusalem. Our announcements for today are, we want to thank all those that supported our praise and motion as they ministered last Sunday for Jamming for Jesus at Great Mount Moriah Baptist Church. Today there will be a soft opening and dedication service for the new fellowship hall following morning service. The Beulah Baptist Sunday School Union will be today at 3 p.m. at Chief Cornerstone. They are asking each church to have a youth to participate in the talent program. Members, if you need or would like to have a copy of your financial contribution records for 2023, please see Jackie Taylor. March 25th, there's gonna be the Unity Choir rehearsal at 6:30. So we're asking all choir members to come out so we can pack this choir stand back here for our Easter Sunday service. And that's gonna be next Sunday at 10 a.m. I have a letter from Gushland Cares. It reads, Dear Reverend Emmanuel and Cecilia Lewis, we're excited to announce the Rotary Club of Gushland and Gushland Cares will be organizing a countywide community food drive scheduled for Saturday, April 27th. In 2023, Gushland Cares provided food for over 2,500 residents struggling with hunger, including children and seniors. Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program benefits were cut at the beginning of last year, and we have seen the need for food assistance increase by 50%. We anticipate that demand will not subside in the foreseeable future. Is your congregation available to help this year? If Jerusalem Baptist Church is interested in participating, please let us know. We can provide flyers, paper bags, and/or boxes. The collection day is Saturday, April 27th from 8 to 4 p.m. If you prefer to conduct a food drive at a different time, that's fine. Please call to arrange a drop-off time. With your help, we will continue to feed Gushland's hungry for many months. Thank you. And then we have a picture. It says Happy Easter from Young Lives Metro Richmond, and I'll post this on the backboard. And Saturday, June 8th from 10 to 4 will be our annual scholarship car and bike show. Registration is $20 from 10 and will be from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. And it's $20 for vendors per table. And all of our donations will go to the JBC Scholarship Fund. Thank you.
Praise God, saints, amen. I don't have much to say. First of all, I just want to say, let's give our youth and our youth workers a hand. God is doing through them. Amen. We're just so excited for everything that's going on here in Jerusalem. And it's just been a true, true blessing. I also wanted to, in the way of recognizing our youth and young adults, definitely young adult now, Tyson is here, and Tyson is now official deputy of Hanover. Amen. Police department. Amen. Sheriff department, excuse me. Amen. So if you caught speeding in Hanover for a donation of $200, all charges will be dropped. Amen. I'm just playing Tyson. Amen. I'm so delighted to see him do great things. Amen. And God has truly been blessing us here in this church. And I'm just so happy to see when they grow up small and grow up big, amen, and do great things in the community. And being a public servant, there's no higher calling. Amen. So we just praise God for you, Tyson. Amen. So they've already announced the resurrection hunt or Easter egg hunt or whatever on next Saturday from 1 to, it's in the bulletin, so I don't want to mess it up, 1 to 3. And our service will be at 10 o'clock a.m. Amen. So we're just so excited. We want to definitely have another full house on Easter as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We also have a baptism of Brother Canton Fountain. Amen. He'll be baptized at 9:30. Amen. Next Sunday morning, so right before our prayer and praise, we'll have a baptism at 9:30 a.m. Amen. 9:30 a.m. we will have a baptism of Brother Canton Fountain. Amen. So we just are so excited that we have another soul for the Lord, and we are still baptizing people. Amen. In Jerusalem Baptist Church. Amen. He's completed all the new members classes, and our youth are just so intelligent. Amen. They are so much more advanced than we were at that age. Amen. Amen. So I'm just so happy that they chose Christ. Amen. We don't want to forget that we have a dedication of our new fellowship hall right after service. It won't be long. We just ask you to stay back, and you'll just walk out the back door, and we'll just have a dedication, a short service, as we want to tell the Lord thank you. Amen. Amen. For this project that has been going on for, I believe, 40 years. Amen. Amen. So this is the generation that got it done. Amen. Praise God for your gifts, your offerings, your support, your encouragement, your diligence, your hard work. But you know the scripture, unless God builds a house, those that build it labor in vain. Amen. Unless God is in the city. Amen. So this is all about God, amen. So we cannot forget that it's not about the building, it's about God working through us in the building, amen. So we intend to put the building to use, amen, to bless everybody in the community, amen. So I believe that's all I have. But I believe I said at the beginning of this year that this was the year of execution, amen. And I said this was building season, amen. And let me explain something. The devil doesn't kill when you talk. But when you begin to build and execute, that's when the enemy starts attacking. Amen. But the good news is we have the victory through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. So God is doing great things in our midst. Amen. So that's all I have. I'm going to get out of your way. We have a powerful word coming forward from the heart of Brother Arterius Rollins. So we have the sermonic selection and the preach word. And we thank our worship leader, Amen, who's done a wonderful job. Amen.
choir one more time. Amen. First, giving honor to God, who is the head of my life. Amen. To my pastor, Reverend Dr. Emmanuel C. Harris, the one and only Reverend Dr. Amen. Amen. To my family who is here with me today, amen. I praise God for you all for being here with me today. I thank you all for being in the presence of the Lord one more time on this Palm Sunday. Amen. This Palm Sunday. Amen. There is a word from the Lord. There is a word from the Lord found in the Gospel according to John, chapter 12. The Gospel according to John, chapter 12. And I'll start my reading at verse 12. Amen. If you have it, please stand for the reading of God's holy word. Amen. I'll conclude my reading at verse 16. The word of God declares, the next day, the great crowd that had come to the festival, they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him, shouting, Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. Jesus found a young donkey and sat on it. As it is written, do not be afraid, daughter of Zion. Look, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt. Verse 16, don't miss this. His disciples did not understand these things at first. Okay, let me read that one more time. His disciples did not understand these things at first. But when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered that these things had been written of him and had been done to him. And the word of God is now blessed. You may be seated in the presence of our good and gracious God. Shall we pray? All wise, sovereign Lord, God of mercy, God of love, reign on us now from heaven above. But God, before we ask you for anything, we just come now just to thank you for everything. God, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. We thank you for your loving kindness. God, we thank you for your love, Jesus, and for going up to a cross and sacrificing your life for the world. Father God, in this moment, I ask that you hide me behind Calvary's cross, so your people may see all of you and none of me. Spirit of the living God, have your way in this place. In the name of Jesus, amen. My title for this Palm Sunday is The Palm Sunday Anticipation. The Palm Sunday Anticipation. Has there ever been a time when you've anticipated something, but it just didn't seem to go your way? Has there ever been a season or time in your life when you had high hopes for getting a job, high hopes of getting accepted into your dream college or university? Or for maybe some of my youth athletes this morning, maybe you tried out for the sports team. The basketball team, the football team, the soccer team, the tennis team. Maybe you tried out for all that, but you didn't make the cut. And you can honestly say this morning, it just didn't seem to work out. When you anticipated something to go left, that thing turned back around and went right. And I'm sure we all have anticipated something to go our way, but like your mama used to tell you, ain't everything gonna go the way you want it to go. But have you really taken time to think about the plan that God has for your life?
Have you ever taken time to think about how God may have to remove some people and remove you from some places in order for you to prosper and flourish? And even though it may not be what you anticipate, the plan that God has for your life is way bigger than you could ever think or imagine. And maybe just about a year ago, when I was very interested in playing two of the church instruments, the keyboard and the organ. I would be playing my imaginary organ on the kitchen table. I'd be rocking my head and going at it. My grandma was like, "Why you keep on banging that table like that, boy?" But I just couldn't get it out of my mind that I wanted to play the keyboard and the organ. But it just didn't seem to work out. And maybe I have a few people here this morning that can say along with me, things haven't always gone the way I anticipated, but God. I came here this morning to tell you God didn't do this to destroy you or because this was a sign he was trying to cut you off. Rather, God had to do this to redirect your life. Today, March 24th, 2024, marks a very significant day known as Palm Sunday. Palm Sunday is in fact the beginning of Holy Week, which commemorates the final week of the earthly ministry of the Lord Jesus Christ. This Sunday we commemorate the triumphal entry of Jesus Christ as he made his way into Jerusalem on a donkey. And I know some of you in the building today are thinking, well, what does the plan that we anticipate and the shift to God's bigger and better plan have to do anything with palm branches? What does it have to do with anything with them shouting, "Hosanna," or "Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord"? And I'm glad you asked that question this morning, because I would love to give a clear explanation on how this text reveals to us that sometimes God has to change our plans to show us his masterpiece and to show us his bigger and better plan. Come along with me as we journey through this text and elaborate on the Palm Sunday anticipation. First, the very thing that you were anticipating may be thrilling and or exciting at the beginning. The very thing that you are anticipating may be thrilling at the beginning. Generally, when we as people anticipate things to happen, we most likely find it thrilling or exciting at the very beginning. We don't look at the negative outcome of the situation. We tend to look on the positive outcome. And it may be something that catches our eye or catches our attention or may be appealing to us. And we anticipate to run and go for it. And even in our text this morning, this crowd or this multitude of people who were waving their palm branches and exclaiming, "Hosanna," found their anticipation to be very exciting in the beginning. The Bible says, it's right there, the next day, the great crowd that had come to the festival, they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and they went out to meet him. They were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel." And this may not mean anything to you just yet, but let me give you some context so you can take off those training wheels and zoom on those two wheels. At this point in our text, when we get to chapter 12 in John's Gospel, we see that pilgrims from mostly all over Galilee have made their way to Jerusalem for Passover and or the Feast of Unleavened Bread. The Passover was celebrated on the 14th day of the month in the evening until the 21st day of the month in the evening, as explained in Exodus chapter 12. Jesus, the Son of God, also came to Jerusalem to celebrate Passover. But before Jesus made his way into Jerusalem, he first had a little dinner at the house of Bethany, also known as the house of Lazarus. And if you read chapter 12, you will know that Jesus has just performed his last and final miracle by raising Lazarus from the dead. The gospel according to John records 7 miracles of Jesus. And the purpose for these miracles are so that the people may believe that he truly is the Messiah and the Son of the Almighty God. As Jesus raises Lazarus from his tomb, there seems to be a crowd that has just witnessed it before their very eyes. They have witnessed the power, the strong and mighty power of the Lord Jesus Christ. And even verse 17 says the same crowd that continued to testify that this man named Jesus was just no ordinary rabbi or teacher, but this man named Jesus was truly a miracle worker. And can I pause right there real quick to tell you that God is still a miracle worker. He's still a promise keeper. He's still your light in the darkness. Don't give up just yet, because the Lord is still on your side. And this is just some context of the scripture, but I want to take just a few minutes to elaborate on the excitement of the crowd. What I realized when I observed this text during my study time is that the Bible doesn't say they said. The Bible doesn't say they mumbled, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. But the Bible says they shouted, Hosanna! Yeah. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Which tells us today, my friends, that this crowd has some excitement about seeing this man named Jesus. They recognized him as the man that had just recently raised the dead man from the grave, and it caught their attention. Here at this point, Jesus has been well known all over Jerusalem because of the miracles he had performed. But what you have to understand is that the crowd was not looking to Jesus as the Messiah that would save them from the depths of their sin. Rather, they were anticipating with excitement that Jesus was going to be the Messiah that would be a military leader and overthrow the Roman rule. The anticipation from the crowd is that Jesus, the Son of God, was going to liberate them from the Romans. Little did they know that God had a bigger and better plan that wouldn't just save them from the Romans, but rather it would save all of us by the shedding of his blood. Can you just tell someone next to you that it's all in the plan? And because it's all in the plan, can I suggest that it's best that you step out the way and let the Lord work it out? Can I suggest that you move out of the way and let God work it out? Can I suggest this morning that you step out the way and let God work out your problem? And just wait. Y'all got happy too quick. The text doesn't stop right there. They go on with this entry by quoting this song that was used by the Jews in the time of Passover season. The Bible says they shouted, Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. The Messiah, the anointed one, is he who comes in the name of the Lord. The crowd was shouting with a loud voice, but they really didn't understand the significance of the coming of the true king that came in the name of the Lord. The anticipation was thrilling, but they just didn't understand what this man named Jesus was all about. But is there anybody in the sanctuary this Palm Sunday that can say, I know who the Lord is for myself? I know what God has done for me. I know who God truly is. I know that the King came to create peace between man, God and man. And you've got to understand that this man named Jesus came to do more than what they anticipated, because God had a bigger and God had a better plan. And the very thing that you are anticipating is going to be thrilling and or appealing at the beginning. The scholarship is going to be thrilling and appealing. The job is going to be appealing and thrilling. The sport may be thrilling and appealing. But just wait until the next chapter of your life to see what God, how God has a bigger and better plan that he's going to reveal. Second and final, God's plan may be hard to understand, but in the end, it will all come together and make sense. Before I close this message, can I just tell you that sometimes God's plan won't always be easy to understand at the beginning. When God begins to open up doors that you never dreamed you would walk in. When God starts giving you things that you didn't even think you deserved. When God begins to deliver you from situations that you thought you would be in for decades, it could be a little bit confusing. You could be saying, Lord, what are you doing? God, I don't deserve any of this. I don't deserve the calling on my life. I don't deserve what you're giving me. But it could be a little bit confusing at the beginning. And what the Lord Jesus Christ is doing here in our text, it confuses the disciples. The Bible says Jesus found a young donkey and he sat on it. As it is written, do not be afraid, daughter of Zion. Look, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's cart. What you have to understand is that the donkey meant that a king was coming in peacefully. But when they saw a king coming in on a horse, it meant that the king was coming for war. But Jesus, he wasn't coming in for no war. He wasn't coming in with any war with swords or shields. Rather, he was trying to do what his heavenly Father had instructed. As Jesus finds this young donkey, he is also fulfilling the prophecy found in Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9, that said that God would give his people a king and he would ride in on a meek animal, also known as the donkey here in this text. As Jesus finds this donkey, and John's gospel explains that his disciples did not understand all these things. They didn't understand why Jesus was on a donkey. They didn't understand why the king entered triumphantly. They didn't understand any of these things, but the Bible says at first. Which tells us something this morning, my friends, that even though you may not understand every little thing that God is doing, God will soon be able to open up your eyes and give you clarity on what he is doing. And even though you could be as a lost man who is in a dark forest, God will soon begin to open up your eyes. And what I really want to focus on in this final point is that the crowd, they were lost. They may have been shouting and laying down palm branches and preparing for this triumphal entry, but they didn't fully understand. As some of you would say, they didn't get the full picture. They were missing bits and pieces. They didn't get the full picture of this triumphal entry. And maybe you didn't get the full picture either. But you still stayed faithful while relying on God to lead the way. But in the end, everything would come together and make sense when Jesus would go up to a cross and sacrifice his life to save hurting people like you and me. This would all begin to come together when they took Jesus from Caiaphas to Pilate's headquarters. This would all begin to make sense when my Jesus was taken up to a place of skull, also known as Golgotha's Hill. The plan would all come together when they hung my Jesus high and they stretched my Jesus wide. And as the old saints would say, Jesus died till the sun refused to shine, and he died till the moon dripped in blood, and he went there on an old rugged cross, but he ain't stayed there too long. And what you have to understand on this Palm Sunday is that Jesus was not coming in for a war, rather he was coming in to create peace. And sometimes the plan won't always make sense, but continue to trust in the Lord and keep your hand in God's hand. And can you just give the Lord a great big praise, because your life has been changed ever since you met a man named Jesus. And can you just wave your hand this morning and say, if you know that the Lord has rescued you and saved you from danger seen and unseen that could have had your life or upside down. Now I can really shout, Hosanna, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Just give the Lord a great big praise. If you know that God truly has a great big plan for your life, and Easter or Resurrection Sunday may not be here yet, but oh, the anticipation. I thank you, Jesus, for all that you've done for me. I thank you, Jesus, for waking me up this morning. I thank you, Jesus, for walking with me and for talking with me and telling me I'm your very own. Go ahead and wave your hand. Go ahead and shout for joy. Go ahead and tell the Lord, thank you. Always gonna make sense.
Yeah.
But God does have a plan.
Yes.
God will begin to open up your eyes.
Yes.
He'll give you clarity on the masterpiece.
Yes, Lord.
So just wait, God is not done yet.
Mm-hmm.
And what I feel like God is saying here in this moment is that he's still writing your story. You may think you're good, but God says, I have more. And I'm done. I'm done right here as the choir sings. The Lord has been faithful. I got sick 2 weeks ago, I think, and I was just praying, you know, God, get me through this. God, get me through this. And I was even wondering, was I going to make it here today? Was I going to have a word for the people of God for this day? I just couldn't seem to get the word right. But I believe it was about Tuesday of this week that God gave me a word for the people of God. The Palm Sunday anticipation. God bless you.
Lord, I love you.
goes forth is never for form and fashion. It's so you may change your life and accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. He didn't pour out his heart for us to be entertained. But God spoke a word through this 15-year-old young man. And many times people don't know your struggles, which you have to go through to get to the pulpit. But I know he was sick. I know he said, I don't feel good. He didn't even know. I said, I don't even know, Pastor, what I have. But he pressed his way. And he wept on that word. And God used him this morning. So I'm going to tell the Lord, thank you, Lord. I don't know what God has for him, but only anticipation of what the Lord's going to do in his life. Only God knows the plans he has for Brother Arterius. Amen. But I tell you what, no degree matters, no doctrine matters if God doesn't anoint you. Amen. And he's already been anointed. So if you don't know the Lord, we want to give you a chance right now. The word is clear. If you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. If you're on Facebook, YouTube, you can put a note in the chat. We'll pray the prayer of salvation with you. The word is clear. If we confess with our mouths the Lord Jesus and believe in our heart that God has raised him from the dead, we will be saved. Is there one? Amen. We're going to ask the choir to have the closing hymn right now. Praise God. Let's thank God one more time for this powerful young man. Amen. Turn right. Amen. And we'll go to the new fellowship hall, amen, and do the dedication. But let's give the Lord a hand one more time for the youth who just led and read, you know, prayed and gave the welcome and did everything. Amen. Amen. That's for the young man who brought the word. Amen. Praise God. Let us go to God. Father God, we thank you for another day. We thank you, Lord God, for the great things you have done, the great things that you are doing, and the great things that you're going to do. We're about to leave this place of worship, but we never ever leave your presence. So may we always, God, thank you and praise you. We know, God, this is a tough week for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The same crowd shouting Hosanna. By Friday, we'll put him on a cross. We know this Monday, Thursday, Good Friday, but then early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hands. We're not there yet, God, but the anticipation is causing us to shout. We know who you are, and we praise you, God, for all the things that you have done. And now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding with the only wise Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore. And the church says, amen. God bless you. See you in the fellowship hall. Amen. You can use either door, amen.